Welcome to Strength of Materials. In this video, we will be seeing related to thick cylinders. This is under module 2. Introduction to thick cylinders. When the ratio of thickness to internal diameter is more than 120, then cylinder shell is known as thick cylinders. Thick cylinders. The hoop stress in case of thick cylinders will be not be uniform across the thickness. It is varying because thickness is there with the cylinder, then it will be more, means thin thickness plate will be having more less stresses, but where the stress in the thick cylinders, initially at the internal surface it will be more, and at the external surface of the cylinder it will be coming with a reducing movement. Actually, the hoop stress will vary from maximum value at the inner circumference to the minimum value at the outer circumference. So this is to make you more clear. So this particular part of the cylinder internal and this particular part of the cylinder external, not so clear, so I'll just make it circular part. In this part, we can see this particular plate here, the stress will be more, and whereas it is coming to reduce at the end, means at this surface. So here the stress will be less because at the internal surface it will be more, and at the external surface or circumference it will be reducing part. So we can see the maximum value of the stress will be at the inner circumference and minimum value at will be the outer circumference for thick cylinders. Stresses in the thick cylinder. So let us see what are the type of stresses. Let us consider a thick cylinder shown in figure below this way. It is a thickness which we are going to consider. A thick cylinder is filled with a fluid and subjected to internal pressure. So already we know the internal pressure is going to act in the cylinder. So here length is there. X-axis is taken, radius 1, R1 is considered as the internal radius, R2 is considered as the external radius of the particular cylinder. Then we are considering the total thickness. In the total thickness, we will take a elementary strip as dx, elementary strip as dx. So when we come to this part, so let R2 be the external radius of the cylinder, then R1 be the internal radius of the cylinder, L be the length of the cylinder. Consider an elementary ring of the cylinder of radius x. So this is at a radius of x, thickness as dx. So this is dx, this is at the radius of x, we can say, as shown in the figure A and B. So these are A and this is B. Let Px is equals to radial pressure on the inner surface of the ring. So in the inner surface of the ring, where the radius is same, so there will be the radial pressure Px, and Px plus dpx as the radial pressure on the outer surface of the ring. So this thickness is dx, so on the outer surface let it be Px plus dpx. Sigma x is equals to hoop stress induced in the ring. Sigma x is equals to hoop stress induced in the ring. Take a longitudinal section xx and consider the equilibrium of half of the ring of as shown of the below figure. So this we will consider at the half of the section. So x is half, then it will be becoming on the both sides the diameter as 2x, and the stresses will be sigma x, which will be acting as the hoop stress in the ring, and Px is the radial pressure on the inner surface. So this way, the when we consider at the external process is acting, so Px plus dpx is acting from the external surface, Px is acting from the internal side, which is, and this is the particular sigma x stresses which will be acting as a hoop stress in the whole circular ring of that particular thick cylinder. Busting force will be coming into account. Now it will be acting as a busting, so that busting will be taken place. So let us solve that part. Px into 2 times xl, 2x, that is 2xl on the length side. Px is circular part. So this part is the Px, this one, and length is acting and it is a diametrical. So for that 2x is acting. So when we consider, then minus, this is acting inside to external, plus external to inside, it is minus. So that is Px plus dPx multiplied by 2 times of x in plus dx. So radius of x internal plus the thickness of the ring dx, both together 2 times diameter of that, at a length, a total length it is. So 2l, taking it as common, Px into x minus of Px into x plus Px into dx. So when we cross multiply everything and simplify, we get this part of equation. In this part, neglecting dpx into dx means we are neglecting this part, okay, dpx and dx, which is a small quantity. So 2l minus of Px. So here when we multiply plus or minus, minus or plus, we get minus Px multiplied by dx minus of x into dpx. So when we take the negative sign on the outside, it will comes as minus 2 times L into bracket P into x into dx, Px dx plus x into dpx. Let it be as the equation number 1. Then comes resisting force equals to hoop stress into area on which is acts. So that is hoop stress sigma x into area which is acting, 2dx into L, the second equation. Equating the resisting force to the busting force, we get sigma x into 2dx L is equals to minus, this we have to equate with the busting force. So equating, we get some as such equation, sigma x is equals to minus px minus of dpx upon x dx as third equation. Then let sigma 2 be the longitudinal stress. Now we have seen the hoop stress. Now we will go with the longitudinal stress. Hence, at any point at a distance x from the center, three principal stresses are acting. They are radial, compressive, Px, hoop stress circumferential tensile stress, sigma x, and longitudinal tensile stress, sigma 2, we will consider. So, the longitudinal strain E2 at this point is given by E2 is equals to sigma 2 upon E minus mu into sigma x upon E plus mu into Px upon E, which we have seen in our module number 1. The similar change in the strain, longitudinal strain equation it is. But longitudinal strain is constant in the thick cylinders. Therefore, sigma 2 upon E minus mu upon sigma x upon E plus mu into Px upon E is equals to, it is a constant part. But sigma 2 is also constant. And for the material of the internal cylinder E, material of the cylinder E and mu, Poisson's ratio, Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio are constant. Therefore, sigma x minus, this part only is remaining now, sigma x minus Px is equal to constant, which is equals to 2 times A, where A is a constant. So, now we will consider the further part. Therefore, sigma x is equals to Px plus 2 times A, taking it as fourth equation in the context. Now, equating the two values of sigma x given by equation number 3 and 4. So, this is equation number 4, and in equation number 3, we have seen this particular part of the equation, this equation in 3. So, taking that, we will be substituting them and equating both together here, sigma x, that is the Px minus Px minus of x dpx, or x, simplifying that, when we comes sigma x dpx divided by sigma dx, if we take it on one side, Px minus Px minus of 2a, it will be taking on the other side. This will come on the right hand side, this part will go on the left hand side. When we comes to this particular part, 2 times Px minus 2 times a. So dpx divided by dx is equals to x coming on the denominator side for both the sigma, minus of 2px divided by x minus of 2a by x. So when we take the LCM part and we take 2 common, minus 2 into bracket px minus plus a bracket close divided by x, or we can say dpx divided by px into a, this is coming on this side, is equals to minus 2 times dx upon x. So now we can easily integrate this equation. Integrating the above equation, we get log of base 2 e px plus a, because it is 1 upon px. A is equals to minus 2 times log e x plus log e b, where log e b is a constant of the integration, constant of a integration. Thus, the above equation can also be written as log e px upon a, px plus a is equals to minus log e x square plus log e b is equals to log e b by x square. Therefore, px plus a is equals to b by x square, or px is equals to b by x square minus a. So, we are rearranging and rewriting them in the equations. So, let us consider this part as the first equation, that is px is equals to b divided by x square minus a. Substituting the values of px in equation number 4. So, this px value we will substitute in the equation number 4. Here, that time equation number 4, we get sigma x is equals to bx upon x square minus a plus 2a. So, which will be equals to minus 1a plus 2a plus 1a is remaining. So, sigma x is equals to b by x square plus a as equation number 2. So, now here equation number 1 and equation number 2. Okay, both. So, we can say this equation number 1 will give us the radial pressure. This will give us the radial pressure, and the particular equation number 2 will give us the hoop stress. So, this part sigma x is equals to b by x square plus a will give us the hoop stress. These two equations are called as Lame's equation for the thick cylinders. We can say this as the Lame's equation in the thick cylinder part. The constants A and B are what? So, obtained from the boundary conditions, which are at x is equals to R1, Px is equals to P0, or the pressure of the fluid inside the cylinder, and at x is equals to R2, radius 1 and radius 2, these are Px is equals to 0 or atmospheric pressure. After knowing the values of A and B, the hoop stress can be calculated at any radius of the thick cylinder. So, this equation, Lame's equation, is most important part in the thick cylinders, because maximum numericals are related with the Lame's equations only, and I will be solving the numericals in the upcoming videos. Thank you, and see you in the next video.